Hey folks, while playing around with Adobe Premiere Elements, I came across a few little tricks that might help you in your video editing. It has to do with controlling your soundtrack and the volume controls over time. There's a few ways to do it. I'm going to show you the down and dirty and simple way. So the video track that I have here is just me changing the air filter on my car, and it's pretty boring. Let me play it just for a few seconds and get the idea of what it sounds like. All right, there was a clip up here, second one, a third one, and also in this bottom cover, there was a clip sort of under. While this is a good how-to video, it's always a little schnazzier to have maybe some soft background music in there, maybe some screaming guitars or who knows what, depending on your taste in music, of course. All right, so this is no news here. Just find the audio track that you like and drag it to your soundtrack track, and when you play it, you get some background music. All right, there's a clip up here, second one. Now, this is obviously way too loud. The music is too loud. Can't hear the narration portion when it starts to talk. So, what you can always do is you can expand the track to show the wavelengths, and you get this little yellow bar on both the video track and the narration or the soundtrack clip track. So, if you drag this down very carefully to, I don't know, maybe. Whatever, very little control there.
One, a third one, and also in this
You can
bottom
hear the
cover,
very
there was a clip
soft
sort of
music in the
underneath this
background.
little
Now that
rubber
might be a
seal.
little bit too quiet, and what I don't want to do is I don't want to have this thing quiet all the time because the point in the video, I'm removing a bunch of bolts. It's pretty boring to watch. I'd rather just stop the talking and have the music crank up a little bit. So how you do that is the easy way is just first of all. Tip number one is drag your tracks a little bit larger so you can actually see the waveforms a lot better. And with that, I have a very fine way to control exactly the volume with that. I can move it just a couple dB very easily. I don't have to worry about trying to be gingerly when I had the window collapse very, like I showed earlier. Something else that I forgot to mention is the microphone that I was using was a mono microphone and it recorded through my camera on one track only. So let me go ahead and fix that. Let me just add an effect to fill left and it will duplicate the right channel to the left channel. Now it doesn't show it in the wavelength here, but when I play it, you'll be able to hear
All right, there was a clip up
left
here.
and right. So depending on the microphone you have, you may or may not have that problem. All right, so back to the real brass tacks here. So what I would like to do is have the music play very loud here at starting point, and right around 2 to 2.5 seconds into it, I would like the voice to kick in and the music to go away. So how you do that is with the soundtrack selected, click this little button right here for add or remove keyframes. There's another way to do this, a second way to do it, but this is just kind of down and dirty on the timeline window here. Then just move it forward or back your slider there just a little bit just to add another keyframe. This gives you a way to control just that portion of the audio or the soundtrack to make it a little quieter or a little softer or a little louder. Same thing with the audio on the video. I really don't want any talking at the very beginning. There's some tools clanking around. Let's go ahead and turn all of that off. So just make a couple keyframes here, and we'll drag the audio for the video all the way down to nothing. So what you'll hear is music loud, no talking, then the talking will kick in.
All right, there was a clip up here, second one, a third one, and also.
Now the music is still a little bit too loud, so we'll just drag this down to maybe 15, 16 dB and maybe get a little more gradual just by dragging these little dots around, these little keyframes around. I can get it to fade in or fade out very gradually.
All right, there was a clip up here, second one, a third one, and also in this bottom cover,
So you can see
there was a
the
clip
music
sort
in the
of underneath this
background,
little
very,
rubber
very
seal over
subtle,
here, one
just
in the
something to
front,
kind of keep
the
the
one
video
over
from
here,
being
so a
so
total of six
boring.
clips.
Now after a point, when it gets a little bit repetitive, I'd like to bring the music back in. So you know the process. Just pick the clip that you want or the track that you want, click the little add remove keyframe button, and at the same time you might as well just select the other clip and add or remove keyframes down there. That way those two are nice and aligned. And then maybe, a second or 2 seconds later, whatever you want to do, select both tracks and add another keyframe to both of them and drag the voice down on the video track and the music up on the soundtrack And that way we have it kind of fading in and fading out at various points in time.
Lift it up, put it to the side.
So this is the repetitive part where I'm removing a bunch of these little covers and nuts and bolts, and I really have nothing of value to say here, so why not have some music in the background. Then somewhere near the end, I actually do have something of value to say, so let's add some keyframes there. And have the music sort of fade back out and the voice fade back in. So after I added a couple of these little keyframes, I can now drag my volume control up or down. Now, it depends on how loud you want things to be and how fast you want them to fade in or fade out. You can play these games all day long to get the exact effect that you want. I have no idea what this will sound like, so let's go ahead and see.
Now that that's out of the way, we can see our air filter underneath this cover. And
all right, a lot more exciting and interesting to watch than me just chewing the fat on removing the covers on your car here. So you get the idea of playing around with this. A couple other things that you can do is, if you notice this, the center portion of the soundtrack, it kind of looks like it's increasing in volume, but I can't really see because of the sound wave. Over on the far left where it says Set Audio Track Display Style, just click that and you can turn the wave spectrum on or off. And then you can drag these around to get a little bit better visibility of that actual volume that you have. So you can toggle that on or off just to kind of get a better idea of what the volume settings look like. You can also do that on the video track if you expand your little video clip. And let me make it bigger, because I like it bigger so I can see. And you can toggle what its display is just by clicking that little button, whether you want the track clip to be shown on the end, nothing on the front or the back, or something in every, you know, 6 or 7 seconds or whatever the spacing there is. So that's another way that you can kind of add a little bit. So if you're trying to figure out, you know, I'd really like the music to stop when I'm grabbing something, you know, right about here. Now you can sort of get a little bit of a preview without having to dance your preview thing around. This is kind of an undocumented thing here that if you notice that the audio tracks or have these little keyframe and the way you can go to the next keyframe or the previous keyframe, but you don't have one of these things to control the visibility or the opacity of the actual video track. So a little trick that you can do, let me just get to the very beginning here. Maybe you want this thing to fade in or fade out or whatever. If you hold your hand on the control key or finger on the control key, you can add these little keyframes up on the actual video track as well. And I'm just adding a bunch here just to show you what you can do with this thing. Now you can drag these things up or down and get all kinds of weird effects with fading on fading in video.
And also in this bottom cover, there was a clip sort of underneath this little rubber sealer in here, one in the front, another one over here. So a total of 6 clips. Getting the cover off, just carefully lift.
Now, this might be better if I have actually something on the video 2 track to have something fade in or fade out, but this is one way that you can do it. There's other ways that you can fade video in or out with a little bit more precise control, but there's just something kind of down and dirty by using this the timeline directly. Other things that are kind of hard to kind of discover here is if you click a one of these little keyframes and right click on it, you can control whether it's a linear progression, a Bezier, or an auto Bezier, or continuous, or hold, so it goes from something to nothing. And why it didn't do my something, there we go, something to nothing, sort of
cover off, just carefully lift it up.
I don't know if I like that effect or not. Let's go back to linear. In fact, let's change this thing to continuous Bezier. And here's where the value of controlling display is very handy. So let me turn this off so I can see everything behind it. I can grab these little blue sliders, and you're going to see the video sort of hide abruptly, and then
there was a clip sort of underneath this little rubber sealer here, one in the front.
It's kind of
another one over here. So a total
of
6 clips. Getting cover off.
Be much better if it were stacked up against a linear. You could see both at the same time. You could do the same thing with the audio as well. Just pick your favorite keyframe, right click, and change it to I don't know, continuous bezier. Just pick whichever options you want, and you can change all of these things. It's going to be a very weird effect here, but you get the idea. I don't like what that did. Let's just go back to normal here for a second and go to just bezier. And we'll grab some of these things, just drag them around, get all kinds of weird effects here. All right, so now as I play this thing,
put it to the side.
You can just, maybe you could hear, that's very subtle, how the music sort of gradually, it gets louder quicker, and then it sort of tapers off. So that's just things that you can play around with controlling the rate of volume control with these little right-click and editing the keyframes here. All right, well, there's like I said, this is just a down and dirty way to do it. There is another way. Maybe I'll shoot another YouTube video a little later on that you could actually go into a special keyframe window, and you have the same kind of control here, but you can control many other things. Control maybe the saturation of your video over time, or control maybe the noise cleaning up of audio over time, and a few other things. So, like I said, this is just a down and dirty way to kind of control your audio. Well, that's it. I hope you learned something, and thanks for watching.